रिक्वेस्ट मिसेस गायत्री सुंदरेशन फॉर अ मंगलाचरण.
विश्वोत्पत्ति विनाश संस्थिति विधौ यस्य प्रसादं मुहुः कांक्षन्ते कमलासन अद्रितनयानाथ अब्धिजावल्लभाः कांक्षन्ते कमलासन अद्रितनयानाथ अब्धिजावल्लभाः नित्यं नित्यं यत्पदपङ्कजे प्रणमतां नित्यं यत्पदपङ्कजे प्रणमतां इष्टा सिद्धिर्नृणाम् तद्विघ्नौघ विघातदक्षचरितं वन्दे गजास्यं महः वन्दे गजास्यं महः वन्दे गजास्यं महः वन्दे गजास्यं महः.
सो आफ्टर लाइटिंग अप लैंप एंड मंगलाचरण लेट अस नाउ I am going to invite Dr. Vijay Bedekar, the chairman of Vidya Prasarak Mandal, to give his welcome speech. Before I do that, let me say something about him. Dr. Bedekar, as I told you, heads the Vidya Prasarak Mandal, which has educational institution often we call from KG to PG, from kindergarten to post-graduation. Very recently, he has embarked on setting up an engineering college at Vaneshwar. Which is about 300 kilometers away from this place. In fact, our first idea was to host this conference there itself because it has a state-of-art facilities. But later on, we decided that the distance between Mumbai to Vaneshwar will be long, so we have changed our mind. Dr. Bedekar is a medical doctor by profession, and he specializes in gynecology. And you know, gynecologists help many pregnant women to deliver their babies safely. I have met some of those babies who he has delivered at many different parts of the world. At the same time, he gives birth to many new ideas. In fact, he is the originator of this idea. Many times he produces ideas so fast that we lag behind in implementing them. By the time we are thinking on first, he has second idea. Many of the colleagues at the Vidya Prasarak Mandal would agree with us. He has been working tirelessly for this conference. I can assure you at least he has been working for 9 months. And that's the time for a baby to grow in the womb. So, without taking much time, I now request Dr. Vijay Bedekar to give his welcome address. He may also like to tell you something about the Vidya Prasarak Mandal, for whom it could be a new thing. Dr. Vijay Bedekar.
Thank you, Dr. Agarkar. Yes, this baby will be born without caesarean, which is a practice nowadays. Let me welcome you all, friends, scholars from India, scholars overseas. I'm greatly thankful to all of you. What a great joy here now. Yes, very briefly I will tell you something about Vidya Prasarak Mandal. This is an educational trust which was started in 1935 as a part of a freedom movement. Those days Thane was a very, very small village. However, then those people become very old and nothing it could progress. So it remained a small primary school till 1957. And I also, my primary school was that school. Then gradually some people from that locality joined the Vidya Prasarak Mandal and the progress started. From primary school they added secondary school. It was a Marathi vernacular medium school. And there was no college in Thane. I had to go to Mumbai to Riya College. So my father was one of those people here in the management. And they struggled very hard to start a college here in Thane. And this is the first college in Thane. This is a 13 acres of land here. And only one building was there then. And now we have a group of colleges. We have a science college, we have an arts and commerce college, we have a law college, we have a polytechnic, we have an engineering college at Vilneshwar, we have an advanced study center, we have a language center. And in this campus, any given day, there are more than 10,000 students taking education from morning till evening. And our school campus is little away, where we have a vernacular medium school and an English medium school now. And there about 7,000 students take education any given day. We want to see that this remains as one of the very highly technologically and quality-wise one of the best institutions here. And our all colleges, I mean the science, arts and commerce, are accredited. A, also they have received best college awards from the university and I think University Grants Commission, the principals can correct me. Our polytechnic was first college in the state of Maharashtra to be awarded or rather give accreditation. We have a management institute also here, state of art management institution. So this city, which grew during last 30, 40 years from a medium, small town to a huge town now, that about 3 million is the population of this town, and some of you are staying in those skyscrapers there, in a jungle, concrete jungle. So the need of town grew and we tried to cater to those needs. That's about Vidya Prasarak Mandal, very briefly. You can go to our website and get more information on that. Second thing, what Dr. Agarkar also said, and maybe Dr. Sharma may also talk on that a bit later. When we decided, and I must acknowledge that, of course, it was Dr. Sharma who first informed me that Dr. Bedekar, there is a 900th birth anniversary in 2014, last year, maybe 1.5 years back when I was in Germany. At Dusseldorf, he informed me. Within 2 or 3 months, for Kyoto Sango and Vidya Prasarak Mandal, we have an exchange program of students. So Dr. Yano also comes here. So when I told him, he immediately endorsed on that. Okay, good, very nice, we must have this. And then, of course, Dr. Sharma, you have received mails from him, and it is he who has designed and done everything for this conference. And of course, his friends, Dr. Ramasubramanyam is sitting in front of me. So I go to him in the some evenings, he stays in IIT and again trouble him. So Dr. Sharma, Dr. Ramasubramanyam and all of you, they have helped me, help us to see that this conference ultimately takes place. I will again say one important thing. It is an educational institution, a modern educational institution, and if you ask me to take a conference on some topic like physics, chemistry, even philosophy, one of the principals is a doctorate in philosophy, and she wants me to take some international conference on philosophy also. Madam, we will do it sometime. So that, to be very honest, would not have been a big problem at all, because they all are experts. The galaxy of people in Mumbai, Pune, we can get locally. when it comes to history of science, history of mathematics, well, Dr. Subramaniam, Ram Subramaniam, you know that I have only you. Of course, Dr. Sharma is in Dusseldorf, Dr. Yano is in Japan. Not an easy thing. And that is a big problem as far as the history of science is concerned. We in India, we lack tremendously. And that's a problem. That's a problem. I personally feel that if India really wants to be ahead in technology, they also will have to know history of science beyond getting involved emotionally and otherwise. That's quite natural, nothing wrong in that. But also academically, they should also see that. They should know at least about contribution of Indians. And some opportunities will have to be given to the science students or arts and commerce students, humanities, to study history of science, not only mathematics, I mean history of science. I don't know, we have a very distinguished guest today who is heading a lot of government bodies in the education and many other areas. No individual or institution like us can easily do that job, other we can obviously have some scholars and offer our libraries and other things, but this is a big job. And not that we don't have that in ENSA is there, or in Delhi it is going on, at many other places you have come it is going on. What I mean is like some big centers. And this center, as a doctor, I know that I require anatomy hall, a physiology hall, biochemistry hall for my education. You require libraries. And to have such libraries, you require good funding. So friends, that's another, that was the intention of Vidya Prasad Rakhmandal, to see that this conference will make some awareness. Not only in Thane and Mumbai, but all India basis, we have informed so many people. It's already on the net. So some beginning we would do, and some people would take it seriously. We also, from behalf of Vidya Prasad Rakhmandal, would try to do something more also, taking some inspiration from this 3 days. And I hope we can add something more. Dr. Ram Subramaniam, we'll be troubling you more. So that was the second point, that why we wanted to have this conference here. Well, friends, as there is no center or no immediate help on this, it was a big problem. When we started reading, obviously David Bingley's entry in the Complete Dictionary of Scientific Biographies, and for Leelavati, he has given 35 commentaries. Some 10-15 for Bijaganita, and some 10-15 for Siddhanta Shiromani. The equal number of books printed. To get a copy of Leelavati is also difficult. You will be surprised in this town of Mumbai and Thane. I mean, new copy. In libraries we can get, we can go to Asiatic Society, we can go to Bombay University, and always obviously get that. Or on the net also they are available, and on our website we have put some of the papers and some copies. My point here is, to organize this conference, whatever such inputs we require are very difficult to get. When we saw that, though it is not a general conference, it's very focused on one mathematician, Bhaskaracharya, it was a bit difficult to get resources. And then I may say that we are celebrating 900th birth anniversary, and maybe that in India we are ready to do that job, that at one place at least we should get on Bhaskaracharya. We would do our best. Vidya Prasad will do, and I would request all scholars here. In your libraries and everywhere you have, please scan them and send them to us. We would put them, and they should be available for future generations. Well, friends, I won't take much of your time because you all are waiting from Dr. Sharma. With this few introductory remarks, I again welcome all of you, and I'm sure you'll enjoy 3 days. He will also explain a bit on the abstract book and other procedures of the conference for your benefit. So with this introductory remarks, thank you, Dr. Agarkar. I take your leave. Thank you.